Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Coffee with Coach Lyle. This is episode 5. If you don't already have one yet, go ahead and grab a cup of Joe. I got a little bourbon-infused coffee. No alcohol, but it tastes pretty damn good. So, first off, thank you for watching my video. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. Give this video a thumbs up. And tell anyone and everyone about my channel if you like it. So appreciate it, guys. So what I want to talk about today is the life of being a coach, a baseball coach. Probably any coach in general, to be honest. The things I go through with teaching kids anywhere from 8 years old up to 18 years old, and even beyond that in college. Some guys I work with, strength and conditioning, that are playing in college. First thing, guys, I love being a coach. I mean, every day I wake up and it's like, oh, I get to go coach baseball, or I get to train guys in lifting and speed, agility. I mean, I love it. I mean, I love what I do. Yeah, can it feel like a job? Yeah, I think anything can feel like a job if you keep doing it. I've been a coach for 10 years now. I played baseball from when I was, 5 years old up to 20 years old. So baseball's been in my life, my entire life, pretty much. But yeah, just life of being a coach. you know, the grind of trying to get your team better. I mean, honestly, it all starts with tryouts, right? I mean, there's no recruiting in select baseball. Yeah, but yeah, tryouts. There's, especially when you have an organization that you're running. The whole marketing, everything you have to put behind it just to get kids to come try out. It's definitely easier getting kids to try out if you have a former Major League Baseball player or a bunch of former pro guys, you know, single A, double A guys running your program or behind your program, because, you know, parents see, oh, come play for so-and-so, this organization, because we have this many pro guy, ex-pro guys that are coaches, and if you come play for us, your kid's gonna be a professional baseball player. Doesn't really work out that way. But parents see that. Oh, they played professional baseball, then I need my kid to go play for them, even though he's 9 years old, and he might not even play baseball when he's in high school. But I need my kid to go play for them because they played pro ball, so they know everything there is about baseball. Yeah, maybe they do. But does it make them a great coach? I don't know. Some are, some aren't. It's crazy how many teams I played against where the coaches are just awful, terrible. I mean, just this past weekend, we played a team and the coach was obviously trying to distract my players, and he was coaching his kids to distract my players. And they're 11 years old, and they're still learning the game of baseball. But hey, whatever you can do to get a win, right? That's what it's all about, winning. Winning makes the world go around, right? So that's another thing with marketing. The more you win, the better your organization is, right? The better coach you are. If you win a lot, that means you're a great coach. It has nothing to do with having 11 really good athletes at 10 years old or 11 years old, 12 years old. If your roster from top to bottom are really good athletes, that means you're a fantastic coach, right? That means that you're the best coach there is, because it's so, so, so hard to coach great athletes, right? Let's say Tom Brady. You know, he goes to the Bucks. He leaves Belichick, goes to the Bucks, and wins the Super Bowl. And what most people think, oh, it has to do all with that coach, right? That coach helped that team win a Super Bowl. It wasn't the talent on the team. It was that coach, right? Yeah, that's how, obviously I'm being sarcastic. That's how parents see that, right? Previous organization I was with, their 13U team is a few years back. Their 13U team was stacked. Absolutely stacked, right? They got some guys that one kid on the team that he's a receiver out of high school now, wide receiver, and he's getting recruited by USC, big time schools like that. So clearly he's not going to be playing baseball. He's been playing football, but he was a freak athlete, right? So I remember the coach, the head coach was an ex-pro, a major league baseball player, ex. And I remember him saying, we were joking, and he was like, I was like, oh, you should go coach my 13U team. I'll coach your team. And he goes, oh, man, I got the hardest job in the world. I just have to sit on the bucket, right? I just got to fill out the roster and sit on the bucket and not say anything because we win. Because that they're such good athletes. Of course, they're going to be a really good team with good athletes when you're 13 years old. When you start getting older and getting to high school, yeah, it's great to have good athletes, but the real baseball players are up here, and a good athlete that's decent at baseball is down here. Now, whenever you're young, if you're a great athlete and you're not that athletic, but you're a pretty good baseball player, it's going to be like this, pretty much. I mean, it's going to be a huge difference. And then it starts getting, you get a little older, get a little older, get a little older, guys start working harder, get a little older, you get into high school, boom, right? You can be a great athlete and a great baseball player. But most of the time, if you constantly work on baseball, working on your craft and everything, then you're gonna be a better baseball player than that natural God-given athlete that's just an athlete, right? You need to be an athlete to be a baseball player. You do. But there's a lot of baseball players that aren't great athletes. You know what I mean? Just because you're a great athlete doesn't make you be a great baseball player. It's all hand-eye coordination, all that stuff. And some guys just naturally have it. Some guys throwing 97 could have a big old belly and don't look that good, and but throws 97 miles an hour, right? Doesn't mean he's a great athlete. He's a great pitcher, right? So there's a lot that goes into that. But what I like to point out is with the whole tryouts, like all these teams, they keep winning because they want to think, because the more you win, they think the more you win, it looks better to parents, because it's all about getting kids out there to tryouts, right? Tryouts, it's a business. Select baseball is a business, right? So a lot of these organizations, that big organizations that have a lot of teams, you know, they have 15U teams, 5 13U teams, 4 12U teams, you know, 3 9U teams. A lot of organizations, they always have a top team, and the bottom two or bottom three are god-awful. And the coaching is terrible. They just throw some guy with, yeah, go coach, whatever. We don't give a crap. Because about that top team, is what brings in kids to try out. That's what brings in all the money. And what a lot of parents don't understand, I know when I was playing, so like baseball, especially in high school, there's a lot of players that can't afford it. And on your top team, there might be like 5 guys that don't even pay. But they have those other crappy teams with not so good players that are making up for those payments, right? So they might have 11 guys, or they might have, you know, 14, 13 guys on a top 17U team, and only like 10 of them are paying. Well, they got 3 other 17U teams with like 18 guys. So those kids are paying, so those parents are actually paying for those top guys. You know what I mean? They just bring in those players to get money. That's what I'm trying to point out. So the whole marketing behind, so like baseball. Oh, we have major league guys, we have pro guys. That's like all it's all about. It's all about showing that, blah, blah, we got all these guys, we got all these pro guys. So your kid is going to get taught by the best and the best, right? They're great at coaches. They know how to coach or whatever, blah, blah, blah. That being said is, just because you're a great baseball player doesn't mean you'll be a great coach. Obviously I feel like that's common sense, but it's not. So what you should be looking for is how much effort and how much a coach is putting into that team and your son or your daughter, whoever they're coaching. How much effort are they putting in? Are they working on the little details? Are they talking to your son? Are they having talks? Are they saying, hey, we need to work on this? Are they working on pickoffs like my 9U team? I mean, we took a whole practice just to work on pickoffs and holding runners, right? Because guess what, 9U? I mean, we played a team the other weekend where we walked a guy and he ran from home all the way to second. And they're just assuming that we can't make the throw. And guess what? They're 9. We don't have the best 9U athletes in the world. I don't have some 9U kid throwing 70 miles an hour, right? I don't have some 9U kid that runs a freaking 5-second 40. You know what I mean? There's very little great athletes at 9 years old. Okay, so there just are these dads that are coaching a lot of these younger teams. It's dads coaching, especially these one-off teams. Like, if it's just a, you never heard of this team, it's just this one team that don't have an organization, it's most likely just dads coaching. And they're going to do everything possible in their power to win a game. They're going to do everything possible because it's all about winning. Winning, winning, winning. It's not about teaching these kids how to play the game the correct way and the respectful way. It's not about that. It's about winning at all costs. And that's what the select ball is now in any select sport. That's what it's all about is winning, right? Because winning gets you players to your tryouts. The more players you get to the tryouts, the more teams you have. The more teams you have, the more money you have. That's a business, right? Our organization runs as a business too. We want more teams, but we think the best way to run an organization is to have two teams per age group. Have a top team, a major, a triple A team, and a double A team. And that's all we need. I mean, we want to make sure we get good coaches, good quality coaches. If we don't have good quality coaches, then everything's going to fall apart. And as a good quality coach, I mean, I honestly would take a coach that has very little experience coaching or in baseball, but they care. They truly, truly care about their players and their team. They'll do everything possible to help these kids. That's the type of coaches I'm looking for our organization, right? We'll help them with coaching. We'll go over stuff. Hey, this is what we should be doing. This is what we should be coaching, but teaching. This is what we want to do, right? I truly believe the way we coach at our organization, or the way I coach, right? The way I see baseball is the correct way of coaching. Yeah, are we going to win a lot? Maybe not. Could we? Yeah, if we have really good athletes and we can coach those really good athletes to be good baseball players and teach them how to play the correct way, yeah, we're going to win a lot. But do we get the best of the best athletes? No, we don't, because we're not trying to have those. We don't have any major league guys that's pushing out, you know, this organization. We don't have that, okay? My light just went out, so we'll just keep going. So we don't have that, right? What is it to be a great coach? I think it's caring, knowing the game of baseball, always learning. You have to always, to be a great coach, you have to always be learning, right? And just the effort you put in, right? So trying to teach these athletes, these baseball players, football players, basketball players, whatever it is, try to teach them the game of baseball, but also teach them life, right? Life experience. You want your athletes, your players, to learn about life through this sport, right? Because that's what youth sports is all about, is life. Being a better person, be a better man, be a better woman, be a better dad, be a better mom, be a better son, whatever it is, just be a better human being. That's what it's about for youth sports. And that gets lost a lot. It really does get lost because it's all about winning. It is what it is. I mean, I wish we were 32-0. That'd be freaking awesome because I hate losing. I absolutely hate losing. I'm mad. I'm pissed off for hours after we lose because I'm such a competitive person. I hate losing. That's how I was in high school. I would be pissed off for the if we lost on a Tuesday, I'd be pissed off all the way till Friday till the next game. I hate losing. It's the worst thing in the world is losing. But I'm not gonna play baseball a different way, the incorrect way, just to win. I'm not gonna teach or coach baseball just to win a 10U game, a 12U game, a 13U. I'm not gonna coach like that. I can't. I can't live with myself not doing the right thing. I really can't. So we're gonna lose? Yeah, we are. It is what it is. But if we lose and I make each player a better person, then we won at life, right? We won at the game of life. If I can coach these kids to be great human beings, great adults when they get older, and use what they learned from me when they were kids or in high school, and to be successful later in life, then guess what? I won. We won. Right? And like I said, I'm a very competitive person. So I'd rather be more competitive at winning the game of life than winning a freaking 10U baseball game. Because guess what? Do you remember if you won, or if all the wins you've won when you were 10 years old, all the rings? Maybe, but I guarantee most likely not. And then I said that to my 90 team. And my assistant coach is he's on my 17 team. He's a junior in high school. And I said, you know, you're not going to remember your wins or losses. And then he told me afterwards, like, shoot, coach, I remember all the losses we had when we were 12, you were 11, you. I said, yeah. And he's like, yeah, but it motivated me to be a better baseball player. I was like, hell yeah, man. Yes, exactly. Use that motivation, right? Put in the freaking work. I got kids, I got 11-year-olds that are just putting in the work day in, day out, lifting, running, agility, and lessons. And I got some parents who are like, oh, well, you know, they do this, but in the game, you know, they crap the bed, blah, blah, and they can't win. Yeah, they do. So what? They're 11. Who the F cares? They're 11. But when they're 14 and 15 years old and they keep working the way they're working, guess what? They're going to be here. Your kid's going to be here. I get fired up because it's ridiculous how what drives me nuts with coaching as a coach is parents. As a coach, there's parents that belittle and put down other kids on a team that are 10, 11 years old. What kind of person does that show how you are if you're talking crap about a 10-year-old? What kind of person are you, right? There's so many fake people in the world, and it drives me nuts that they say one thing, but in real life, they say one thing, oh, yeah, it's all, oh, good job, but in real life, they're talking crap about a 10-year-old, 11-year-old. So that shows you what kind of crappy person you are. And I would say it to your face, to be honest. I'd be like, you know what? You're a crappy person because you belittle kids. They're kids. They're trying their hardest. So what? They're going to live and they're going to learn. You make mistakes, you learn from it. It is what it is. So I think every coach is going to say this. Every youth coach is going to say this. The worst thing, the absolutely worst thing about coaching is parents. The parents that don't get it. They just don't get it. They think we need to have meetings because we're not winning enough in 11U. It's like, dude, relax. They're 11, and they're gonna learn, and they're gonna live, and they're gonna learn. They're gonna get better. Okay, that's what it is. I don't need to have a meeting about an 11-year-old 11U team that's not winning enough. I don't need to do that. That's absolutely ridiculous. Okay, and there's parents that. His parents said, awesome, that, you know, the loyal ones are the ones that get it, right? The kids that jump from team to team each season, they might be 1 year with a team and then a season with another team and then go to another team. Or even see every season they jump team to team. How do you expect your kid to get better at baseball if they're only staying one season per coach? Each coach coaches differently. How is a coach supposed to help a kid get better if they only have them for 3 months? It's impossible. Absolutely impossible. You have to put in, you have to trust. I know I always say trust the process. I know, baseball is a process. It's going to take a long time to get better at baseball. Any sport takes a long time to get better, but these parents want it now. We want to win now. Win now, win now, win now at all costs. If we're not winning, that means my son's not getting better at baseball. It's all about winning. I don't want my son to be the best on the team. I want him to be with other kids that are going to push him and be better. Well, how about your kid be a leader? Because isn't that what we're all about? We're about building leaders. Do you want your kid to be a leader in life? Do you want him to be a CEO of a company? Or do you want him to be a follower? Does he always need to be with better people to get him better? Or can he just take the responsibility of himself to get better? That's what drives me. That's the worst thing I ever hear from a parent. I don't want my kid to be the best on the team. Well, I'm sorry. I didn't know your kid was the best on the team. But even if he is, how about he steps up and be a leader and help these other kids get better? Because what I understand is better to be a leader in life than to be a follower in life. That's what I understand. But maybe I'm wrong. Maybe you always want to be a follower. Maybe that's what life's about. But what do I know, right? All these parents know way more than I do, right? Any coach will say that. All these parents know more than we do, right? The grass is always greener somewhere else, right? Until they go to that place and then they come back, right? It's like, oh, well, actually, yeah, all the other stuff sucks out there, right? Oh, this coach was belittling my kid. He was always screaming at him, telling him he wasn't any good and all this stuff. Or these kids were making fun of my son on the team. Or there's bullies. The grass is always greener, right? The grass is always greener. Because it's all about winning at all costs. That's all it's about. That's what youth sports is about, winning at all costs. That's how most parents see that. But in reality, it's not that. It's about winning in the game of life. It's not about winning a freaking 13U baseball game. It's about winning the game of life. It's about helping these kids be better human beings, better adults, right? Man, I got so fired up, I lost track of what I was doing. So yeah, the whole marketing behind it, tryouts, right? You got to try to get all these kids. I don't know, the worst thing about tryouts is like, you can't see how the parents are. I wish we could have tryouts for the parents, right? I wish I could ask the parents all these questions. Hey, fill out this form, ask these questions out, because I want to see what your personality is, right? Because you could get great kids. There could be a stud player. You're pushing to get this kid. You're talking to his parents. The parents are cool. The tryouts. You're building up your organization. You're like, yeah, I mean, we're going to do all this stuff. And you get that kid, and he's a freaking stud, right? And then 2 weeks into the season, the parents are terrible. Always emailing you, calling you. We need to have meetings. We need to do this. Why aren't we winning enough? It's like, no coach wants that. Don't be that parent. Do not be that parent, because those are the absolute worst. I mean, I'll kick a kid off the team that I like a lot if the parent is terrible. Like, I'm not going to – it's youth sports, okay? Relax. I know you're paying money, and a lot of people – I mean, from our organization, we're pretty cheap for around here. There's people that pay $2,600 for a season, right? $2,000 for a 9U season, right? I know youth sports is a lot of money, but sometimes as a parent – you need to take a step back and let your kid learn from other people and get built up, right? So one of the biggest things, whenever I was growing up, I lacked a lot of confidence, right? Because my dad was so hard on me. I mean, you struck out twice. What are we doing, boy? You dropped the fly ball. He was so hard on me that my confidence was just always going lower and lower and lower, right? But I had coaches that would help build up my confidence. And if you don't have confidence as an athlete or a baseball player, you cannot play well. It's just impossible. If you have no confidence, you cannot play well. I remember used to being so freaking nervous, like being at bat and be like, oh God, I hope I don't strike out because it's going to suck. Right. I was so scared. So scared. But throughout my career, I had so many amazing coaches that helped with my confidence. So many. I mean, I can't thank them enough. I mean, even now, like, I work for two of the coaches that coached me when I was in high school. And I've been working for them for 10 years. And I was 19 when I worked with them, and now I'm 30 years old. So going on 11 years. And the mentors they have been to me to help me where I am today is insane, right? So even when I was 19, I didn't really know. I mean, when you're 19, you don't know anything, right? I didn't know what I wanted to do with my life. And I was like, yeah, I guess I'll start working in the facility. Oh, you want to start doing lessons? Yeah, I'll start doing lessons. Oh, you want to help coach? Yeah, I'll help coach. I learned so much about baseball after I was done playing through coaching, right? Coaching is, it helped me. The more you coach something, the better you're going to be at that thing, right? So if you're, say you're, in math, right? So if your kid's taking math and he's struggling in math, if he learns how to do it and then he teaches someone else how to do it, he's gonna know it a lot better, right? So that's how coaching it was for me. I learned so much more about baseball, about life, and about myself through coaching. And thank you to my two mentors, right? And I still go to them. I still ask them questions to this day. I mean, if I don't know something in life, or if like anything happens in my life, I'll text them or call them and be like, what do I do in this situation? What do I need to do right here? And they're helping me. And that's what a coach is being. That's what coaching is all about to me. I want to be able to be there. So whenever the guys I'm coaching now are older, when they go to college or when they're getting married or doing all this stuff, having kids, I want them to be able to text me or call me, like, hey, coach. And I want them, hopefully they still call me coach, even when I'm like 50 and they're 30. It's like, coach, I got this problem going on, man. I just need some advice. And I want to be that person, because life is all about leaving a legacy, right? What's your legacy in life? What are you doing to whenever you're on your deathbed, when you're at your funeral, who's going to be there? What kind of things are they going to say? Even after you're gone, like, in this world, it's all about leaving a legacy. It's not about how much money you make, because at the end of the day, unless you want to take all your cash out and be buried with your money, when you die, you have nothing. You're done, right? It's all about the legacy you leave in this world after you're gone. That's what it is for me. Yeah, do I struggle day in, day out, and I'm just like, oh, I get so frustrated with these kids, because they're kids, and like, you say something over and over and over again, and they don't get it yet, and it's just so frustrating. And then sometimes I'm like, man, coach this kid for 3 years and he still doesn't get it. What the heck? Like, what am I doing wrong? Am I not a good coach? I'm always second guessing myself. Am I not doing what I'm supposed to be doing? And sometimes I'm like, I don't want to do this anymore. Like, sometimes I'm like, I don't want to coach anymore. Like, I'm so tired of this, but it's who I am. I'm a coach. It's who I am. It's in my blood. Now it is. Like, I've been doing it for going on 9 or 10 years, and it's like, it's who I am. It's Coach Lyle. It's not just Lyle, it's Coach Lyle. Even though some of my guys say Lyle, I'm like, hey, it's Coach Lyle. I know we're boys and we're cool and everything, but I'm not your friend, I'm your coach. First, it's coach and then friend, right? shout out to Ty McCovey. Stop calling me Lyle, call me Coach. But yeah, it's who I am. So the whole marketing behind it, that is what it is, right? So you get the team, you start coaching. Of course, there's going to be parents that get upset about something, blah, 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 we're not winning enough. I think we should be doing this. I'd like to help out. It's like, well, sorry, we don't have parents help out. It is what it is. And thank you for your advice, but this is how I'm going to do it. Yeah, sometimes I'll be like, you know what? Yeah, I can understand that. Okay, yeah, I get it. I'll look into that. And sometimes I get parents saying stuff. I'm just like, dude, whew, you do not get it. You do not get it at all. And it's sometimes it's comical, and sometimes I get very frustrated and I get mad. I get pissed off, and I can be a very blunt person. I'm very patient at times, but once I get upset, it's just like, you know, screw you kind of mentality. It's like, I'm doing the best I am doing. I'm trying to get these kids to be better, and I'm putting all my effort and all I care and all the care that I have, excuse me, into this. And these parents just don't get it. But yeah, guys. So I'm actually running out of time because I'm gonna have to get ready for work in a little bit. But this is episode 5 of Coffee with Coach Lyle. Thank you again for watching this video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. If you like this video, leave it in the comments. And yeah, please subscribe to my channel and hit that like button. I'll do episode 6 probably at the end of the week, and I will continue where I left off in this video. So yeah, thank you guys, and have a blessed day.